These are my grades.
How can anybody get a D in home ec?
If that's none of your business, can you erase this, please?
No, it's too late.
What are you doing?
I'm changing your biology grade.
No, I don't want you to do that. You're going to get me in trouble.
No, nobody can find out. There, you just got a C. Now you don't have to go to summer school.
Change it back.
Why? They can't possibly...
I said change it back.
Okay, okay.
Gee, that's great. Now that we can plug into the school's computer, the next step is to plug into the Defense Department's computer and start World War III and War Games, a movie about a teenager who's just a little too clever with his computer. It's one of four new movies we'll be reviewing this week, and across the aisle from me is Gene Siskel, film critic of the Chicago Tribune.
And across the aisle from me, Roger Ebert, film critic of the Chicago Sun-Times. Now, in addition to War Games, we'll also be reviewing a boxing picture in which a country singer finds out whether he's tough enough. Also, a political mystery called Harlequin with a weird magician. But now Roger begins with the first of the summer's new 3D movies.
Well, our first movie is called Space Hunter. It's subtitled Adventures in the Forbidden Zone. And this is the first of a whole deluge of 3D movies that are scheduled for release later this summer, including Jaws 3D, mm-hmm. Amityville 3D. The sad thing is Space Hunter is entertaining enough in 2D that 3D only slows it down and kind of destroys the fun. The movie stars Peter Strauss as a buccaneering spaceman who answers a mayday call from a spaceship that's crashed on a plague planet. And his mission is to rescue the marooned spacers before the locals kill him or he dies of the plague. And in this scene, he teams up with an orphaned Earthling who lives on the planet, and she's played by Molly Ringwald.
For the next year.
Vicky?
Good breeding, man. I'll bet breeding with us would kill him.
I'll take that bet.
Later in the film, Strauss enters the Forbidden Zone, populated by creatures half dead from the plague.
We can be friends. Just let me go.
No, you don't understand. I'm very old, and I need you. You tired, little one? Of course you are. You see, when you give yourself to me, there's nothing left for you.
I love that absolutely standard music that's out of every space movie ever made. Space Hunter is not a, you know what I mean? This movie is not a masterpiece, but it's a reasonably entertaining movie. It has some good performances in it. And here's my question. If you're going to go to all the trouble to make a good movie, why mess it up with 3D? Because no matter what they say about these new 3D processes, they all make the picture look dim, look murky, and washed out on the screen, and the 3D effects themselves are only a distraction from a good story. Looking at those same scenes in 2D right here on television, I can relate to them a lot better than I was ducking to get out of the way of the foreground in the movie theater. And frankly, I can't recommend this movie in 3D, but if it turned up on cable or on television, I'd look at it.
And if it turned up on cable or television, I wouldn't. I think this is an awful picture if it were in 1D. All it is he picks up this girl. Will they get together or will they won't? What do you think's going to happen? Then they get to the cave. 5 minutes, the movie's over after he confronts that guy they call the overdog, that creep hung up there with the heavy breathing. I thought this was an empty little movie, and your point about special 3D is well taken. All that is effective are the titles that come way out. The rest of it, you look like you're looking through a telescope.
They do not. They brag, as a matter of fact, that they don't throw a lot of things at the audience.
I would have preferred that.
The question would be, if you're not going to throw things at the audience, why do it in 3D? I defend it, though, as a basic kind of 50s space opera, a silly kind of let's go to another planet and run around and have adventures and look at strange things kind of movie.
I thought it was less interesting than any of the Star Wars pictures that are shot in 2D, and this is a ripoff to me.
Well, I'm not recommending it, if that'll make you any happier.
It'll make me any happier, okay. Coming up next at the movies, the story of a young video game player who comes close to starting World War III.
I have 7, correction, 8. That's 8 red birds, 2 degrees past apogee.
Over day, we have Soviet missile warning. Check for malfunction and report confidence.